It's your students here.
Okay, guys, ready to go. Welcome back to Real or Real with Anu, season 2. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, now today's episode, as you all must have guessed, is a Valentine's special. Why? Today is 14th of February. And to celebrate and discuss love.
Oh.
Okay? Okay, fine. Okay, what love means in the 21st century, yeah, in today's day, okay? Forget that. I want to welcome all my good friends, the young, beautiful, dashing members of the extended ITA family. Sameer Soni.
Yay, hi. Hey guys.
Neha Pense.
Hey, Neha.
Thank you.
Daljeet Kaur.
Daljeet, hello.
Hello.
Ejaz Khan.
Can't miss him.
Mandana Karimi. And we're just waiting for one more. He should be walking in any minute.
He'll walk anyway.
But anyway, we're going to get started. Okay, guys, I'm going to introduce you all first. And after that, we keep it open for all.
Chalo.
So I'm going to tell you things which hopefully a lot of things you know, a lot of things you may not know about these young, handsome.
Can we check what you want to tell people?
We should tell before you.
And if anywhere for a moment I've gone wrong, you'll dare correct me.
You know how many cameras we are live? We better correct you.
Okay, now Sameer Soni was born in London.
Tera pehli galti hui.
Okay, he's a St. Xavier's alumni.
Correct.
Right?
Yes.
And did you graduate from the University of Los Angeles,
California,
Los Angeles, UCLA?
Yep.
Guys, he's a UCLA graduate.
Lovely.
Wow. Wow.
Would you have ever guessed that?
No.
You were working as an investment banker.
Correct.
On Wall Street.
Yes. Wow. Really?
Guys, now all of a sudden.
Wolf of a Wall Street.
Just look at it.
A different perspective to this guy.
My respect bad gaya.
Okay, he was he's working on Wall Street as a broker in New York.
Oh, you used to do all like.
Oh God.
Think about it, okay? And after that, he left all that.
Ouch.
For his passion for acting, yes, and moved to Mumbai.
Correct.
Sameer today is an actor, a model, a director, a producer. Yeah. And he made his debut on Hindi on television in 1995.
Correct.
Wow. Now that was years ago. He played popular
before
roles.
Before you guys were born, so yeah.
Yeah, maybe. I think referring to me.
No, I'm okay with that.
Not the women, please.
Okay, done. Sameer.
I know
Sameer. Sameer is married to a beautiful, very good friend of mine, Neelam Kothari, who I will talk about later.
Yeah, you have connection with that.
That I'll talk about later, and he has a beautiful daughter.
Oh, mashallah. Oh.
Sameer also was, now the reason I'm going to tell you, appeared in the reality show Big Boss. Now, reason I mentioned Big Boss, you'll know gradually as I go.
Okay.
Am I right, Sameer? Okay, so that is about Sameer. He loves reading books.
Nice.
Can you imagine a Wall Street graduate moves to Bombay, becomes an actor?
Actors.
It's like all of a sudden you look at Sameer with like different eyes. What happened? What happened, Sameer?
No, actually, acting was my passion. I started acting and doing theater when I was about 8 years old. So it was very clear in my mind I wanted to be an actor, but you know, coming from a typical middle class Punjabi family, you have to study. Academics are important.
Oh, yes.
And incidentally, I was good in studies. My brother was in America, so I got admission there. So I finished my graduation in finance. So I said, theek hai, ab jo acting karne do. And then there were companies coming on campus to recruit. And because I was decent, I said, chalo, kar lete hain. So I got a job on the Wall Street in investment banking.
Wow.
And that's the job my brother wanted and he never got it. So he said, are you mad? Are you going to give up the job? Like, yeah, but I want to act. I want to go home and act. He said, nee, kar le. So 2 years I was working in mergers and acquisitions at the investment bank.
How was it?
I hated it.
Oh.
I was working like 60 hours a week.
It was okay.
Yeah, it's like, you know, yeah. No, honestly,
but you had a flair for numbers and flair for that.
Yeah, but
it's fascinating today.
Wow.
But today, I guess, because it's really
today.
Maybe then it was not as huge and large.
Maybe so.
No, but you know, after a while, it gets too much because you're sitting, in the end, you're sitting in front of a computer, you're going through annual reports, you're looking at numbers together. And I'm basically a creative person. So.
But you never did acting. You never learned acting.
That's not right. When I was in New York for 1 year, I was taking method acting, Lee Strasberg classes I was taking.
Okay.
Just to feel alive. So I used to work all day. The evening I used to go for my class.
Wow.
So, yeah. In the end, I got really fed up. And I remember writing a letter to my dad. I said, Dad, I don't want to be 40 years old with a wife and 2 kids and a house in suburbs and say, you know, your father could have been a good actor, but he didn't have enough guts to do it. So I chucked my job.
Living the dream.
Wow.
Yes. You actually did it.
I
gave up all that and you moved back.
Yeah, it was. And for 1 year, no one spoke to me at home. mom dad said अरे ये एक्टिंग ही करनी थी, इतना पढ़ने लिखने की क्या जरूरत थी, ऐसे ही कर लेते तुम जाओ.
Why does everybody say that?
No, but I think times have changed today. At that time, acting was not a profession or even a career option.
But I would love to add on this probably when things come to me. I don't want to break his flow, but about this, I will talk.
Okay. And then how did you get into acting when you came back here?
Acting, I went to Delhi, then I came to Bombay. I met couple. I didn't know soul because I'm originally from Delhi. I didn't know anyone in Bombay. And I realized that, you know, breaking into films was very difficult. So, because you don't know anyone. I remember meeting Mahesh Bhatt once, and then he was like, I don't know what to do with you. I mean, you know, so, I mean, I was like, yeah, okay, whatever. So, then I had my portfolio. So, I went from one production house to another production house to say, chalo, this is easier. Because you come, you audition, and you go.
And you go, right.
And the second day, I got a commercial. In fact, I did the ad for the first ever cell phone in India.
Motorola. Oh, wow. Really? So you've been literally one step ahead in the technology space.
Wow. Yeah, so the first Motorola was the first one that came in. That was my first ad. And that was, I got the second day when I came to Bombay. So
Well, this was the universe telling you, you've got to be here and get more followers today.
So I got the right decision. I got
lucky. The right decision.
I got
my
lucky.
God, you need these signs. Otherwise.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Wow. So I got pretty lucky.
Okay, and then Sameer married Neelam. Can I tell you all a little story, guys, about
Neelam? Yes, please.
Okay. I was sitting one day at Bangkok airport, okay? And my flight got delayed. So I'm sitting at the airport and in walks in Neelam. So I was sitting with Neelam and we started talking, but the flight was delayed, I think 2, 3, 4, 5 hours. I don't know how many hours. And I was sitting and talking, and Neelam, I knew about her earlier, and I knew of her, and I knew her earlier. So we started talking, and Neelam, shaadi nahi karni. Kehti, yeah, karni hai. I said, do you have anyone in mind? She says, I have someone in mind, but I don't know. So she told me 2, 3 sentences. I don't know if he wants to. I don't know if we can. I don't know if he will. Or if he will. Oh, various things related to questions. That. Or if we can. Okay. I said, chalo, baat khatam ho gayi. I come back. 2 days later, I go for dinner to Sanjay Gupta's house. We're sitting at Sanjay Gupta's house. Sameer hai, Rohit, all of us there. So koi baat hui. I said, Sameer, shaadi kar yaar. Kehta hai, pata nahi if I can, I don't know if I will. And the same identical dialogue. So I said, Sameer, I know who you're out with. He said, I said, I know who you're going to get married.
Really?
He said, he's sitting here. So I said, I know who it is.
It was a bizarre
question. You with that?
Just the dialogue, they sounded they were so identical.
She said, yesterday I met her at the flight. I'm like, what?
Yeah. And I said, you're married. Neelam, but how are you talking about? She said, oh my God.
You guys married,
oh my God. And they got married after that.
Yeah, got married. Wow. The interesting story
but good,
is,
stop cracking it.
You know what was the most
thank you.
Most bizarre thing was, I mean, people have heard this, but the most bizarre thing about us getting married and stuff was she had come to see my play with the Ekta, the play I was doing. And I heard through someone that she said, this boy is cute. Yeah, that's all. I heard. She says sweet. Okay, whatever.
But she's cute.
So whatever. So I was like, yeah, okay, fine. You know, whatever. So we have different circles and everything. So I didn't meet her or talk to her. I went to a tarot card reader.
Damn.
Do you remember Ofer? I went to him because I was like, okay. So he saw the card. He said, look, there's a girl who's gonna come in your life, and her name's gonna start with the N.
Really?
So I'm like thinking all the girls I know. I'm like, who's the N? It says she'll do something with fine jewelry.
Oh shit! Are you serious?
I'm serious. I swear to God. And I said, okay. So I said that's only Neelam, but I hardly know her. But then I started paying attention to her. Then I was like, And then there's a long saga.
You owe a lot to that tarot card.
I think she kind of channelized you towards her.
This is the best story I've heard on Valentine's
Day. Yeah, this is a love story of Neelam and Sameer.
It's like she had the tarot card reader channelized him to her.
After that, 3 years, we would bump into each other once or twice a year. I didn't have the guts to ask her out. So I'd say, oh, I'll call you. and finally, when I did call her, it was, I think, Ekta's Diwali party. And my friends, they got fed up of me saying, oh, she's so cute. So look, if she is, then call her. So I decided to call her and it was 3 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, really?
Ouch.
And then anyway, so.
Okay. And that is the last time. That's Sameer's Valentine's story.
Damn, my Valentine.
So cute. Yeah.
Okay.
It's a true Valentine.
It's a truth. Now I'm going to introduce Neha to you. Neha is an Indian film television actress. She started working when she was 8 years old as a child actor.
Yes.
Oh, opposite with Nana Patekar in the same film?
Yes.
You all guys didn't know that.
No, that is Samrat.
Okay. She's been brought up in Bombay. She did her schooling here. She started then working in Zee Marathi, Bhagya Lakshmi.
That's right.
She's acted in Marathi, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, and Hindi films.
And English.
And English. So she's totally bilingual.
Wow.
She was also a contestant on Big Boss.
Hey,
two of them.
That.
Okay.
That's
she has done a show opposite Kapil as a presenter.
Yes.
But I must tell you one thing about her. Neha was called the hottest Marathi actress. And ask me why. What is it when you think of
I
all...
I didn't like that.
Okay. Hottest.
Hottest.
Should I did that? Sorry. No. I mean,
we all had that. We had an image going through.
I'm sorry. If a guy did that, that would have been me too, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
If
a
bloody... Guys, it's Valentine's.
How can she do that?
It's Valentine's spirit, guys. Come on.
But Buster was... Apni to lag gayi.
Vandana, you're on my side?
I'm on her side.
Okay, then.
Because,
if you didn't pay attention.
You know, I was like, okay. I haven't noticed it yet, but I don't know.
Okay, so I think I'm going to help her a little bit, as she asked before. She wasn't like hot. She was like hot.
Yeah. I did this. I said,
the hands were a little higher. No, but she was coming on that.
Yeah.
Oh, shut up. Well,
you okay, okay, now we're talking about her. Okay, let's and ask me why. Now, when we all of you
because
all of you have been discussing how much weight you lose, how much how you don't eat, how much whatever related to weight loss. Neha was known to have the perfect body, which was 36, 24, 36. Yeah. That is the reason she was the hottest.
Can you just stand up for a minute?
Not now.
But now let me see what she does. She got hot now.
Can you imagine? Not. That is what so she was. Know. She was literally considered.
She was popular for because of that.
Because Sameer, we spent thousands and lakhs and time and energy into becoming that. We
good
still
job, girl. Good job.
They
very
say,
well done.
You know, all my friends say after my kid, it's taken me 2 years to stay in the 30s. I still haven't lost.
But I think I think I'm also popular for more valid reasons.
No. That was a special talent and pretty reason.
That's a very big
compliment. So, no acting, no talent.
Why you want that?
34, 26, 34.
Uske pehle maine bataya hai, Marathi, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Hindi, English. She's acted in all
but this overshadows
it. It takes over. Oh, God.
These are horrible people. Let's be honest. Okay, now tell me one thing. You are not married. You have anybody... Today, you can confess to us.
Yeah.
Anybody you wanted to, you wish to be with for the rest of your life?
My ex.
Oh.
What happened?
What happened?
Who is that idiot?
What's his
name?
I am sorry.
You can come here.
Okay, tell us what's his name.
Okay, I will not tell his name because he's...
He's an ex now.
No, not because he's an ex. I was very, I'm very guarded about my...
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
Just said in front of a million people.
But they don't know who the person is.
Yeah,
but he'll know, right?
But he knows
Sameer, it.
Of course,
I think some
Google.
How do I know?
Yeah?
Everyone
must be Googling.
No, because he's pretty shy that way.
He's not in the industry.
Not at all. He's a scientist.
He's a scientist.
Yes.
Arey,
yaar, what is
this
scientist?
Researcher, scientist. And that's about it. One more.
But why didn't it work out?
He just acted a little off track and then things just...
Yeah, okay, he acted off track.
Yeah. And
off track.
Weird. No, I love him. I can't talk shit about him.
Fair enough.
Say nice things.
But he wants to, you know, want
so
to
So can we can...
No, I think more than that, I feel he's the only man that I have ever connected in my life. And at the end of it, like today, let's say, as all independent women out here, we don't need man for anything else except for companionship.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
I think most guys will agree before women. So we can
take care of ourselves. We are independent. We are everything. But what you're looking for is connection eventually. And I haven't found any connection before him and after him.
Why didn't it work out with him? Are network badlo yaar tumhara.
I think
happy Valentine's.
Okay, listen.
I don't know about your ex or your relationship with that particular person, but I think sometimes, you know, that person we connect so well, but unfortunately it's not a right time for us to be with them. Or maybe from their side as well.
Maybe.
Probably he has loved you as well. But
no, he did.
Exactly,
he absolutely
right?
Did.
But it wasn't a right time, right place for you guys to be with.
But you're not married. He's not married.
That it means oh God, love is that's not enough.
Huh?
Yeah, Yeah, of course, love is not enough.
He loved her.
Yeah, oh, but there was a lot more.
No, hold on. Oh gosh, I really have to reveal everything now.
Might as well.
He now works for Harvard. And he obviously doing his research and all that stuff. So the bottom line is, it was always a long distance relationship.
Yeah, that's wrong place, right?
You are not willing to move where he is.
I did at one point. That's the reason we pursued the relationship.
Okay.
At one point he started behaving very weird, which made me question the whole relationship. And
you shouldn't be saying this on camera.
Aww.
He should be.
Why not?
Weird. Why are you saying that?
No, she's talking about their relationship, not his. He behaved weird.
But he, listen, he's not here to defend himself.
We'll get him next time.
Whoever you are, I'm fighting for you. Okay.
And also, why I'm saying this is because I know that I would like to say that I've not done anything wrong. And he knows that he's done things wrong.
Oh my God.
No, I don't mind.
But he's not married with anybody yet.
Okay, that I can't reveal.
So if he's not, the chances, you know, you never know. It's like the universe comes back. Like she You're said, talking
that,
about
that time
today.
Okay. The time maybe now is.
If he hears this and he says, listen, now. Yeah, I want to marry you. Would he say that now? And but do you want, will you marry him?
I would love to marry him if he comes here. I can't go there.
See, now conditions are.
Because I took my chance once. Maybe you moved on.
I was ready to do that then. Yes.
Maybe today you're not ready because there's more happening. You feel
there is a lot more for you. Honestly, no. I really do value love a lot in my life because I haven't received it a lot. So, but I just feel that at times, since we are talking about love,
right.
What love is practically and what love is theoretically are two different things.
I will agree with you there 100%.
So that's what this experience taught me, that practicality and theoretically are two different things and you need to be practical after a point.
Yeah,
I think she's right.
But also the fact that there's love still,
which is fine.
We love many people, right? We love a lot of our friends, but we can't be with them like, all the time, right? You have a lot of friends who are living in some other countries.
प्यार आपको बार बार हो सकता है किसी से भी हो सकता है खतरनाक चीज जो होती है इश्क वो आपको एक ही बार होता है और ऐसा होता है ना मतलब
समीर तेरा इश्क तो हो चुका नेहा का भी आई थिंक लग रहा है होने वाला
है आई एम वेरी हैप्पी थैंक गॉड
ओके नेक्स्ट आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस दलजीत नाउ दलजीत इज एन एक्ट्रेस हु वन हु स्टार्टेड आउट बाय विनिंग द मिस पुणे टाइटल
यस
Very good. And she was a finalist in a lot of other pageants like the Miss Navy, Miss Mumbai, Miss Maharashtra Queen, a lot of beauty pageants. Daljeet was right there. Wow. She then did Nach Baliye with her partner then, Charlene, and she won that. So she's a brilliant dancer, guys. Post that now. She, the only one in this room, she's refused Big Boss at least 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
No offense. Now I'm getting encouraged.
Now she's waiting for the phone call. Okay, now we're going on to Daljeet. Daljeet was married to Charlene, who they were both working together. Yes. They fell in love, and I tell you, at that time, a lot of TV stars all married each other.
We did 12 TV couples at that time married each other, I think.
Because I've done a lot of shows together, but it doesn't work like that.
Because you had a scientist on the side now. I mean, if you don't have somebody on the side, though.
She's right. You had somebody. They were totally here.
On one side was scientist Dada. Yeah. Hello.
Okay. So Daljeet then married Charlene.
Yes.
They have a little baby boy.
Yes.
That Valentine's story didn't end very well. So yes. we're getting on to that. Yes. They are now separated. She has come out of it very well because I remember meeting her when she was at her rock bottom. Yes. I had met her with her son, with her mom, with her parents. They were going through a terrible time. It was like traumatic for all of them. And but Charlene was there on the upper. Now I think times and tables have changed because she's now totally over with it. She's very well settled, very well back into work with her little boy. Family is taking care. Everybody then, I honestly don't know where Charlene is, but I remember him messaging me once.
Really?
Yes, he did. I must tell you. I think I've never told you. He messaged me once that to please tell you that I am now more settled like I was earlier and I will ensure that I don't make Daljeet unhappy again.
Aww.
That's how long, if you don't mind, how long were you guys married?
We were married for 6 years.
Oh, wow.
We have a 5-year-old son. Wow. Now, I've been separated for about 3 to 4 years.
But you guys haven't gone through a divorce yet?
The divorce is done. It's about done, 2 years.
But the baby was about 1-2 years old.
Yes, that time he was barely 1.5. But I have to mention this now that, you know, she's saying, I remember the first person that came to my mind was her when I had nowhere to go. I didn't know who to ask for help. I didn't have absolutely no influence or, you know, contacts or whatever. But I remember coming to you and Shashi sir. And I can never forget that day. And my mom, she's right. My mom was sitting. My kid was here. And we were lost. We didn't know how to kind of do things. And I just remember that so fondly. And that connects me to you on a very, very beautiful level.
And I remember after we spoke to her, I said, Daljeet, do you want to be with him? She said, yes, because of my baby. So we called him. So we said, let's at least, because sometimes you never know, you know, you go on a wrong track
and
you just need to see things clearly to say, okay, guys. But I think at that time it wasn't meant to be.
But like I think some things are just not meant to be. And maybe. I'm very happy and very, I think in a very dignified way, I'll say this, that I think we both have found our peace.
Fair enough.
I am a very happy mom today. I love my kid. I love my life. I have figured out my career again. I was 86 at one point of time. I am 57, 58 now.
Wow. Well
so that's, that was, I think, a very big achievement for me. I didn't think this career will give me another chance because, you know, people think of you as a mother.
I think Tony Dia gave you. You started
I got Kala Tika I owe them so much because I needed work. I needed the confidence to believe that even with a kid.
I could do it.
I could do it. So I got that show Kala Tika as a mother. And then actually that helped me in a lot of ways, but also it took my career a little behind because I was this really hot and nice and like, you know, when I had the baby and now suddenly I was being called only for mother's role. Yeah. It was very difficult at that time. And then so I kind of went into a shell for about 1.5 years. But then I think then Balaji happened and Ekta ma'am gave me such a nice, cute role and it's got me back again in the main radar and it's...
But your son, he sees the both of you, you're together as when need be as a family?
Yeah, I can say that. Like I meet Charlene on and off and he's very respectful towards us. He has, like I said, he has found his peace, which honestly I was praying for him as well. Yeah. And like you said in the beginning, there is no... that I'm doing well, he's doing well. There's no conversation. He means well for Jaden. I know that for sure.
Right.
And I like to believe in my heart that's a fact that's going to remain. And that's, I think, for the well-being of Jaden.
But tell me one thing. Will you, because you're very young.
Yes.
Will you, if you do find, marry again and move on with life? Because you can't, it's very easy. Like she said, Neha, you need somebody for companionship. More than anything in life, it's very easy to say, I don't like men or I don't like women or whatever. Yeah. But the fact is at the end of the day, when you get back, it's just the fact that you're with somebody. Correct. You need company that loneliness can kill you further. Oh,
These conversations I have almost every day because my dad mom live with me and I'm a Punjabi, like a Sadarni. So, you know, Punjabis have this conversation every day and my mom dad are always saying, settle ho ja, settle ho ja. But I think in my head now, I am somewhere prepared because I do realize the importance. More than, I wouldn't say only for Jaden, for myself, I do believe what you say, that, you know, you go back to somebody.
Right.
So, I think I've started looking into that light, but it'll take me a while.
Well, the fact that you open.
I was going to ask, I mean, it's like a personal thing, but how do you explain it to your son? I mean,
so,
that's a tricky situation.
You know, I was very fortunate, Sameer, that when we separated, he was 1.5 years old. Mm-hmm. So, he knew nothing.
You know better.
And I separated when he could barely speak or understand. Yeah, so, now he's 5 and he's only seen me. Like, I drop him to school, I pick him up, I take him out. He meets Charlene on and off, but it's actually worked in a betterment for both of us. Because he knows, like,
but does he say Papa or?
Of course he does.
But
and
he meets
I tell him.
Him
that
he meets him.
He meets
yeah,
him.
Yeah.
I make sure that
him as
of
Papa.
Course. Of oh, okay. And I like to do that because it's, you know, I don't want Jaden to be in a feeling of I'm deprived of.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's beautiful, and in fact, once in a while, whenever they meet, they have a good bond. And Jaden is too young to, so he's not popped the question of where is my dad or what's going to happen. So I'm happy that I'm kind of escaped.
He just knows that dad is there. He doesn't
live
with us.
He knows, and they meet in a very good space. And that has, I think, everyone who meets Jaden, touchwood, always says that he's a very happy kid. And that after the whole fiasco, it's that's all that matters.
So good. So now this is another happy Valentine.
Yes, absolutely. Right. My Valentine is Jaden, and I'm very happy to have my Valentine home.
Now we come to the man
in the pink,
very fantastic pink suit,
a
hot pink suit. Okay, this is Ajaz Khan. Now, you all know him as an Indian television and film actor. He started and he's acted in a lot of television programming. He was also the wildcard entry, not once, twice in Big Boss. So, therefore, he makes up for you.
No, I can't. He went there twice.
So, that means there's
a huge... I'll talk to you later.
Okay, another thing about him, he's married. He has a lovely little son he dotes on. I've seen his photographs with him always. But he runs an NGO, I don't know if you all know.
Oh, wow.
Called
wow.
Allah Ke Bande.
Oh, lovely man.
Here he helps poor irrespective of caste, creed, age, etc. Wow. Am I right?
Wow.
Hi, lovely man. Wow.
Now tell me one thing. What is Allah Ke Bande? What is it that, and how do you got started it, and how do you go about taking care of all of them?
It's a very emotional thing, you know, like my mother, unko liver cirrhosis ho gaya tha. And she was my life, like, bachpan se main mom ke saath hi.
Okay.
I'm a slumdog millionaire, so you can say that.
Oh, okay.
So she used to do everything for me, like mujhe kuch life mein ban jaun uske liye. To bada ho gaya main, hum log yahan pe aa gaye, and suddenly I came to know that doctor ne bola, bhai, 2 saal hai inke paas. And I was like, no man, you're not God. So somehow I believe in Allah Ta'ala so much. And I said, Allah Ta'ala, koi zariya banao ke meri maa mere saath reh jaye. And trust me, ये लोगों के लिए भी मैं कहूँगा कि यकीन जो होता है वो बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है. And I was crying sitting in Rock, Warsaw, with my friend, and एक फोन आता है मुझे. दे यार एजाज भाई, एक लड़का है, उसके हार्ट में सुराग है और धारावी में रहते हैं और बहुत उनकी मतलब हालत खराब है. अगर अब भी एडमिट नहीं किया तो वो लड़का मर जाएगा. मैं काम कर उसको लेके वर्सोवा आ जाओ तुम लोग. तो वो लोग आ गए, मैंने लड़के को देखा, मैं बोला यार हाउ आर यू. एकदम पतला सा हो गया था वो, एंड ही वाज हिज नेम वाज तारिक ताहिर. तो ताहिर वाज लाइक प्योर. तो मैंने उसको पूछा, मैंने क्या जीने का है? बोलता है हाँ. तो यार ठीक है, हम तेरे साथ है, फिर चलो. मैं उसको कोकिलाबेन हॉस्पिटल लेके गया, एंड दे लाइक यू हैव टू पे 15 लाख्स बिकॉज वी हैव टू do this and all this. मतलब you know, मतलब धीरूभाई अंबानी के पास पैसा है, कहाँ से आया सबको पता है. तो मैंने वो किया, और वो लड़के के लिए मेरे को एक ख्याल आया सडनली कि यार अगर मैं ये चीज करूं, एंड आई प्रे नमाज, एंड आई से अल्लाह ताला शायद तुमने इसको मेरे लिए भेजा है. और वहां से ही अल्लाह के बंदे का मुझे ख्याल आके वो लड़के को मैंने वहां पे आंदोलन किया, वहां पे मैंने मेरे फैंस को बुलाया, वहां बैठा. सडनली आई सॉ दैट 5-7 हज़ार लोग आ गए, बिकॉज अंबानी हॉस्पिटल में तो लूटा जा रहा है. मतलब आप चले गए तो किडनी कैंसर ये वो, बी केयरफुल हाँ प्लीज.
ये लाइव है,
कुछ नहीं मैं कुछ नहीं कर सकती.
तो उस लड़के को मैं बचा तो नहीं पाया, लेकिन डॉक्टर ने बोला था कि ये 10-15 दिन में मर जाएगा. लेकिन उसने अपनी जिंदगी, वैन ही वॉज लाइक डॉक्टर सेड दैट, आज उसकी माँ का फोन आया कि आप लास्ट डे. मैं 3 महीना उसके साथ ही था अंबानी में. तो लड़के को मेरे को उसने बोला कि मेरे को तुमसे मिलने का अकेले में. तो ऐसे तो मैं है हट्टा कट्टा, लेकिन अंदर से एकदम थोड़ा सा
हिला हुआ.
हाँ मैं गया, वो ऐसा बैठा था सामने, एंड इट्स लाइक हीरो अभी मेरा टाइम आ गया है. आई वाज लाइक क्या बात कर रहा है पागल, ऐसी बात मत कर. वी वर कनेक्ट सो वेल. एंड देन ही सेड आपकी मम्मी को कुछ नहीं होगा. एंड आई वाज लाइक क्या बात कर रहा है यार. ट्रस्ट मी, 10 इयर्स माय मदर
सर्वाइव
विद मी. डॉक्टर सेड के लीवर सिरोसिस जब एंड होता है मतलब वहां से 10 साल जीना मतलब मेरेकल, मतलब इतना मेरेकल उनके साथ. तो फिर मैंने सोचा कि अब मेरे को ये काम करना ही है.
तो देन एंड नाउ,
एंड नाउ ऑल्सो आई एम लाइक बट दिस वर्क इज वेरी
फुलफिलिंग.
हेट यू लाइक यू नो यू हैव टू फाइट. बिकॉज गरीब लोगों का वो हाल है इस कंट्री में कि आप गरीब हो ना तो आपको बीमारी हुई तो आपको मरना ही है.
आप कहां से आए हो? आप कहां से? वेयर वर यू ब्रॉट अप?
बेसिकली
यू सेड आई एम अ स्लमडॉग मिलियनेयर, मींस व्हाट?
हां, तो माय फादर इज अ वेरी रिच मैन, लाइक यू कैन सी माय पिंक सूट एंड यू. सो माय मदर वाज वेरी खुददार एक औरत. मेरे डैड की 2 शादी हुई.
अच्छा,
ऐसा नहीं कि वो ऐसे थे, पर अब तो मेरी मॉम ने बोला नहीं भाई मैं तो उसको लेके चली जाऊंगी. डिवोर्स नहीं लिया उन्होंने, ऐसी मोहब्बत थी कि एंड तक दोनों साथ में ही थे, पर एक ईगो होता है ना आसपास का, तो उसमें वो मुझे लेके चले गए कि मैं इसको हीरो बनाऊंगी. एंड आई बिकम, अब स्लम में रहने के बाद तो आदमी क्या बनता है, अभी बिकम लाइक अ गैंगस्टर, दैट राउडी गाय, दैट कम ऑन एग्रेसिव. व्हाई दिस पीपल आर वेरी एग्रेसिव, बिकॉज दे थिंक यार हमको कुछ मिला ही नहीं.
बट आप वहां से रहे थे, यू एक्चुअली वर लिविंग इन द स्लम्स.
यस यस.
सो यू हैव काइंड ऑफ कम आउट ऑफ देयर.
आई कुड नॉट स्पीक इंग्लिश.
हां,
हिंदी प्रॉपरली नहीं आता था मुझे.
फॉर
दैट पीपल माई फैमिली यूज टू ब्लेम माई मदर, कि अगर तूने ये नहीं किया होता तो ये नहीं होता. एंड शी वाज सेइंग कि एक दिन आएगा,
दिखाएगा सबको,
ये सबको दिखाएगा,
मतलब गली बॉय जो कहते हैं.
एंड
सबका टाइम आएगा.
आई केम हियर, आई डिड इट, एंड इंशाल्लाह आई लर्न, बिकॉज लर्निंग इज एवरीथिंग इन लाइफ. यू कैन लर्न एनीथिंग.
बट टेल मी, यू आर मैरिड टू नॉट एन इंडियन गर्ल.
या
सो मतलब इंग्लिश आपने सीखी. शी इज फ्रॉम वेयर? रशिया.
एक्चुअली क्या हुआ,
दिस इज हिज लव स्टोरी गाइस.
या द लैंग्वेज ऑफ
लव. ओ, बिफोर वन सेकंड, वी वेलकम आवर नेक्स्ट गेस्ट, मिस्टर प्रियांक शर्मा.
सॉरी, आई
एम सो
सॉरी. इट्स
ओके. हाय गाइस.
हाय हाय
जी, नेहा, समीर, प्रियांक. अच्छा, इसको स्पेशल हग मिला है.
He's the only one who's getting all the hugs.
Okay, come.
I have the promotions actually right now. How about you?
Samir's getting all the hugs from everyone
today. Yeah, what's going on?
तो मुझे इंग्लिश नहीं आती थी, अंग्रेज लड़कियां मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगती थी. NIFT में एक लड़की से मिला, उसने बोला यार तुम अंग्रेज दिखते हो. अब मुझे इंग्लिश नहीं आती थी, तो उसने मतलब मेरा दोस्त साथ में रहता था, मेरे ट्रांसलेट कर क्या बोल रही हो. बोला भाई, बोल रही है तुम्हारी आंखें बहुत अच्छी है और तुम दिखते अच्छे हो. तो मैंने बोला इसको बोल फिर चलते कॉफी. लेकिन बात क्या करेंगे, बोले
आती बोली तो आती नहीं.
मैंने कहा तू साथ में रहे, उसको साथ में लेके ऐसे. वहां से मुझे रियलाइज हुआ कि यार इनके साथ इंग्लिश बोलने में सर, क्योंकि टूटा फूटा भी बोल लेता था मैं. यू नो व्हाट, आया क्या, ओके, नो 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 प्रॉब्लम. अब कोई इंडियन के साथ बोलेंगे तो बोले भाई अंग्रेजी नहीं आती आपको. अबे हिंदी हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा है भाई.
सही बात है. सही.
और आज हिंदी बोलने में लोगों को शर्म आती है.
हाँ, सही है.
तो मैंने वहां से ये डिसाइड किया कि भाई अगर अंग्रेज लड़कियां तुम्हारी गर्लफ्रेंड रहेंगी
तो अंग्रेजी सीखना
पड़ेगा.
आ जाएगी भाई, वरना तुम्हें कोई सिखा नहीं पाएगा. तो इतनी सारी एक्सेंट मेरे अंदर आ गई, रशियन कभी कभी सारा प्यार कभी नहीं हुआ मेरे को.
ले,
अंग्रेज लोग बड़े सीधे होते हैं, सच्चे होते हैं.
थैंक यू.
अभी हिंदुस्तान
में बैठी है एक अंग्रेज.
नहीं, मैं हिंदुस्तान में क्या है, हिंदुस्तान में मतलब हमारा क्या होता है कि हमको इतनी सारी कंडीशंस लाइफ में बचपन से,
दैट इज अ फैक्ट.
ऐसा करोगे तो ये हो जाएगा,
ये नहीं करोगे तो ये होएगा.
ऐसा उन लोग को क्या एकदम बिल्कुल मतलब
लिव योर लाइफ.
अगर आई लव यू है तो आई लव यू है. मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि
कंडीशन
आपके साथ मुझे हम बिस्तरी करनी है या मुझे आपके साथ ऐसी एक्स करना है तो मैं आई लव यू बोल के कर लूंगा यार फिर, और बाद में आपका दिल भी.
क्यों, इंडियंस के साथ ये होता है?
इंडियन लड़की को बोलना पड़ता है ना,
टफ होता है,
क्योंकि उनको बिकॉज दे फील लाइक दैट दैट आई बी लाइक अ,
समझ
गए ना,
बोलने ही ना,
तो वो हाँ वो जज करते हैं ना लोग यहाँ पे.
या, 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 या.
तो उसकी भी कोई गलती नहीं है. अब ये हमें हमारी बीवी जो है वो हमें, हमारे एक दोस्त ने फोन किया रात को बॉम्बे में कि भाई तो लड़कियां बहुत खूबसूरत आई है,
तुम्हारे दोस्त को रहती कहाँ है
भाई, आया कोई आया वो एक्चुअली नोवेटल में खाना खा रहा था रात को 2 बजे
क्यों लड़कियां यार भाई को फोन लगाने का भाई वो आ रहा है
रात को 2 बजे खाना खा रहा था वो तो उसने देखा कि 2 लड़कियां बैठा, उसने बोला भाई
अकेला
को बुलाओ अकेले तो कुछ, तो उसने फोन किया तो मैं बोला ठीक है आ रहे हम भी यही है कोई बात नहीं मतलब नेकी और पूछ पूछ अब मैं जाके मैं देखा मैंने कहा यार लड़कियां तो बड़ी खूबसूरत है माशाल्लाह, इसने बोला भाई बात कौन करेगा, हमने कहा हम बात करते हैं चलो, हमने जाके टूटी फूटी इंग्लिश में बात किया उनसे, मैंने बोला हाय हाउ आर यू माय नेम इज एजे अब ये मुझे नहीं पता कि इसका मीनिंग क्या है, मैंने कहा स्टैंड फॉर क्या होता है, मैंने कहा स्टैंडिंग एजे स्टैंड फॉर, बोला यार मैंने बोला नो नो एजे एजाज खान यू सी गूगल एक्टिंग 2-3 सीरियल ये वो ऐसा वैसा
दिखा दिया,
वो बोली आई डोंट केयर यू नो लाइक, अब वो बिरयानी खा रही थी तो मैंने कहा देखो ऐसे बिरयानी चम्मच से नहीं खाते हाथ से खाते, अब अंग्रेज का हाथ से खाना बोले तो मतलब
बोले तो
वो चम्मच से खा रही
थी
बिरयानी हाथ से खिला दिया, तो बहुत ऑनेस्ट लड़की है, मतलब मैंने जिंदगी में ऐसी लड़की नहीं देखी, हमने लाइफ में ऐसी लड़की देखी नहीं ना कभी देखेंगे,
बट शी फेल फॉर यू,
हाँ मतलब पठान आदमी हम भी मतलब
माशाल्लाह वैसे अंग्रेज दिखते हैं
बिना मेकअप के चेहरा लाल है हमारा,
देख लो देख लो हाँ।
तो उनने कहा कि कल सुबह हमारी फ्लाइट है, क्योंकि उनकी फ्लाइट मिस हो गई थी, पेरिस जा रहे थे, बर्फ गिरी थी बहुत, शी इज फ्रॉम हॉलैंड, तो उनको एक दिन का स्टे यहाँ पे दिया था एयरलाइंस, हाँ शी इज डच,
ओके थी देयर वाज अ मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग, नोबडी न्यू व्हाट नेशनलिटी, एजाज इज मैरिड टू अ डच गर्ल,
डच गर्ल,
वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट रशियन,
सो देन शी सेड दैट वी आर गोइंग टुमारो, अब साहब मेरे को पहली बार ऐसा फील हुआ लाला भाई तुमको मोहब्बत हो गई है यार, इतनी अंग्रेज तुम्हें मिली कभी जाती है दुख नहीं हुआ तुम्हें, इसको एयरपोर्ट छोड़ने जाने के टाइम पे मैंने बोला यार भाई कुछ हो गया तुमको यार,
ये वैलेंटाइन की कहानी है,
कुछ हो गया, अब शी सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग, तो आई सेड
नेहा टेक क्यू फ्रॉम देयर, यू वांट समथिंग गो फॉर इट,
गो फॉर इट,
डोंट लेट हिम गो,
इसे पहले
अब मैंने कह दिया उससे एयरपोर्ट पे, एयरपोर्ट पे कह दिया मैंने, क्या मैंने कहा आई लव यू, व्हाट यू क्रेजी, आई लव यू लाइक 2 डेज यू फॉल इन लव विद मी, प्लीज डोंट गिव मी दिस इंडियन शिट, ओके यू लव मी यू प्रूव इट, देखो गलत आदमी से कह रही हो प्रूफ करने के लिए,
दिल पे ले ली बात,
बोलती ओके आई एम गोइंग टुमारो, मे बी यू कैन कम ऑन क्रिसमस, दिसंबर था वो, 21 को हम मिले थे,
25 को आप कहां
पहुंचे, 22 को वो चली गई, 23 को हमें जाना था यूएस लॉस एंजलिस, हमारे दोस्त की शादी थी,
ओहो,
और हमने कहा यार बेस्ट फ्रेंड भी है और वहां भी, इसने कहा कि यू कैन प्रूव मी, हमने कहा एक काम करो टिकट कैंसिल करो, हॉलैंड का टिकट कराओ, हॉलैंड का टिकट, हमारी माँ बोलती कहाँ जा रहा है, मैंने कहा माँ गोरी से प्यार हो गया तुझे भी इंग्लिश सीखनी पड़ेगी
तुझे भी इंग्लिश सीखनी पड़ेगी,
बोले यार ना मेरा एक ही बेटा है हाँ मैं कैसे बात करूंगी उससे, और ये माँ साहब हो जाएगा सात समंदर पार जा रहा है कोई रख लिया मेरे बच्चे को एक ही है ये वो अपना लेके बैठे, मैंने माँ आप जाना तो पड़ेगा, अब हाईलाइट ये मैं फोन किया मैं पहुंच गया उधर, और उधर भाई एयरपोर्ट बंद बर्फ गिर रही है और ये फोन ही नहीं उठा रही है, मैंने कहा लाला भाई तुमको बड़ा शौक है यार अब ले लो कर लो 2 घंटा फोन ही नहीं उठा रही है, मैंने कहा या अल्लाह अब क्या होगा, अब 2.25 घंटा हो गया मैं बैठा फोन आया उसका, hey, I'm so sorry, यार, this is snowing and all this. I just left my house and I'm coming. अरे मेला गोरी मैम कहाँ है आप जल्दी आइए हम डर गए, लेके आई मुझे घर लेके गई सीधा, अब भाई मुसलमान आदमी गोरों के लिए तो टेररिस्ट है
नाम पठान है उसके माँ बाप बोले माँ बाप बोले मुस्लिम
नो नो
Muslim, very good Muslim.
Saying namaz 5 times,
what more do you want?
I'm not Laden. No. He's not Muslim. They are Muslim, good Muslim. Ab uske maa baap bole, bhai, you know each other, okay? First see Holland, ye wo. Hum Holland ghumaye, humko Christmas mein, ye wo. Phir humko pata chal gaya, humko pyar ho gaya, yaar. Humne kaha, shaadi karogi humse?
She said yes.
Boliye, shaadi? Give me 1 hour. I'll think about it. मैंने कहा भाई मना ही करेगी क्योंकि अब पूछेगी ये वो ऐसा वैसा. मैंने कहा एक घंटा ठीक है, एक घंटा आप ले लीजिए, हम आते हैं. एक घंटे के बाद उसने
yes बोला.
बोला okay.
Okay guys, give him a hand for the girl. Forget him making a decision in 2 minutes. She made up her mind in 2 minutes.
Yeah,
now I think that is one real.
That's one hell of a Valentine.
Next
story.
Time you meet her, please tell her from all our sides.
It's a big thing. For a guy like me, she left the country, religion, friends, language, culture, everything. तो मतलब मैंने बोला भाई तुम इतना छोड़ के आई हो यार, अब तुमने हमको खरीद लिया यार lifetime के लिए.
Oh, nice.
Really?
So good.
This is exactly what I wanted.
This is what she wanted. See, she said that he.
This is what I wanted for.
अरे पर जाने मन तुम भी तो जाओ हमारे.
हाँ.
मैं जाने वाली थी, वही तो कह रही हूँ, मैं तो शादी करके जाने वाली थी.
नहीं जाके ले आओ खींच के शादी करके.
नहीं नहीं, नहीं क्यों यार,
बट इफ
इनको प्रैक्टिकल होना है थोड़ा सा.
नहीं इनको प्रैक्टिकल तो अब हुआ है
ठोकर खाने के बाद.
या दैट इज डिफरेंट नाउ.
प्रैक्टिकल तो अब हुआ है.
नाउ वी गोइंग टू गो टू इंट्रोड्यूस मंदना करीमी.
यस,
मंदना इज मनीजे करीमी इज हर नेम गाइस. यू गॉट अ ब्यूटीफुल नेम मनीजे. शी चेंज्ड इट टू मंदना.
एक्चुअली आई हैवंट चेंज्ड इट.
इट्स
अ वेरी मिसकंसेप्शन दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल थिंक आई चेंज्ड माय नेम. So I belong to a very mixed background.
Okay.
My father was Muslim. Huh. My mom, she's Parsi.
Right. Oh. So therefore, yes. Manize and
yes. And Mandana is actually given by my grandmother.
Okay.
Who she was a nurse and she used to work with this Indian doctor in Iran, and her name was Mandana. So I've been named after that.
Yeah. But you grew up in Iran, is it?
Yes. And unfortunately, the government of Iran, they didn't allow Mandana in my pass, in my ID. So my mom had to choose another name for my ID. So
therefore, Manize. Okay, guys, now you know why she's Bandana. She's a very successful model. But before that, she used to fly for Malaysian Airways?
No.
Okay,
not that.
Were you an air hostess ever?
I didn't reach that point.
But you wanted to get to that
yes,
point.
So I'm okay. Trained flight attendant basically in Dubai.
Okay.
So there is a course that you need to take for almost like 12 months.
Uh-huh.
So I finished that course. And 1 week before I actually officially became, I was like, no, I can't do this.
And then you wanted to be an actress?
No.
Oh,
it just happened like way.
Okay. And now you were from Iran. You went to Dubai.
Yeah.
You did your training to be an air hostess. Last minute, you changed your mind. You were also, then you moved to India.
Yeah.
You're a model over here.
Yeah.
You've done a lot of films here. You've done television over here. You speak Hindi, English and Persian.
Yes.
And one more thing, guys, in common, once again, she was also on Big Boss 9.
Yes.
Yeah. Everyone here gang. Is from Big Boss. This is a common thing.
Big Boss?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right here.
All of us. That's what I said, Big Boss gang.
Big Boss gang.
Boss gang.
Now, tell me one thing. Vandana was married. So then you decided to stay in India without any family. You've been living here alone.
Yeah.
You got married a year or so ago.
Yeah.
But then obviously I think that didn't work out for reasons that you two didn't get along with each other.
Yeah.
And was that something which hit you? Was it traumatic? Was it something which just happened? Was it meant to be? When you got married to a boy from India, totally away from where you come from, how was that? How did the family take it? How did you want to do that?
So... let me just take you back a little bit when I just left Iran. So when I was 16, I moved to Dubai with my stepfather and he used to stay there with my mom. So I moved there to kind of figure out what I want to do with my life because I'm coming from a very strict Muslim family. So if you look at my school pictures, it's all burqa.
Yeah.
Right. I saw that.
Like
I
fully
saw that.
Covered. I had to pray 5 times. I had to be in certain ways, right? And when my mom and my dad, they separated when I was 11, my mom, she remarried the Indian doctor when I was 12. So suddenly, from being that, I was introduced to TV, to different languages.
Where I was told used to watch Sholay all the time.
Sholay was when I was much younger. So my father, it was only in our house, in the neighborhood, that he had, you know, the cassettes and all that.
VHS.
Yeah.
VHS.
So that was like the first Hindi film that I watched because it's really popular back home. Yeah. But I didn't watch it by my parents knowing it. Oh. I watched it with my older brother, who actually played it for us to see, ooh, what was it, you know, they were watching.
But Iran was so strict as they say it was?
Yeah, it was.
Okay. Yeah, it is strict.
Yeah, so what happened is that I traveled, you know, to many different countries. I've lived in many different countries, from Hong Kong, from US and Malaysia and Singapore. So when I came here, I felt some sort of a, I'm home.
Affinity to the country.
Yeah, and also like the thing was... No, I think it's not about being white. I think it was.
लड़का भी बाहर से आता
है. It's not. No,
it's. Upen Patel, ये वो बाहर से तो लड़कियाँ they like it, you know, like.
No, it's not about being likable because we are white.
But you are beautiful, Masha.
No, I'll correct you. Why a lot of white girls they like India? Because even as Iranian,
I was going to ask you what attracted you to
India. See, even as an Iranian, right? My culture is very similar to India, right? But when you travel to Europe or US, people are so busy in their own life, right? I mean, I don't like New York. And the reason I don't like New York is because people are so straight. It's just all about them, their work and everything. And you come to India suddenly. So I remember when I got here for my first shoot in Chennai, I was shooting for Ever Youth.
How did you get into Indian shoot?
Yeah, oh my God. Indian shoot is like really interesting because...
But you didn't come to India to be a model.
No.
You just were visiting.
No, I wasn't even visiting. I was in Malaysia. Huh. I was a model. I was modeling. And my agent said, oh, you've been confirmed for this shoot. You should be very excited because you're shooting with the big next thing in India. I'm like, who's that? Like, what? I don't want to go to India. I don't like India. And she's like... No, that time because I had a thing with my stepfather and I was like, I don't like India. You know, kids, how you feel with the new man in your mother's...
Right.
So when she said India, I was like, I'm not going to India. She's like, no, you're shooting here in Malaysia. And there's a guy called Virat Kohli. He was a teenager. He was a teenager that time. And she said, yeah, he's going to be the, you know...
Next big thing.
Yeah, all that. So anyhow, I shot that commercial. And apparently that commercial did well in India. And then I got another commercial in Thailand. Then it just was back to back.
One after the other.
I think after 9 months, I got a contract for 2 months in Mumbai. And that's how it happened.
Wow.
You're just meant to be.
Yeah. For sure.
If only you had held on to Virat Kohli. If only you had held on to him.
Yeah. That could be another story.
God gave it to you on a platter.
You kicked it off.
Yeah. And I remember talking to him on set and, you know, it was a lot of us we were shooting and that time my English or even Hindi was very bad because I just
Ajaz is another one like you right here.
Yeah. So now, I was talking to him and he's like, so what do you want to do in your life? Like, I'm like, I don't know. I'm just like having fun in life. The modeling thing is great. And I think this whole doing commercial is really fun. I really like the camera. And then he corrected me. He's like, listen, your English is really bad. The grammar that you just used, it's really like messed up. So just correct that first and then think about anything
else. Then come here.
Yeah.
Okay. So then how did you meet your, how did you get married? Okay, let's get to that.
Okay, getting back to my marriage, which was a surprise to people that they know me. From my best friends and my mom, because I never been that girl who wants to get married.
Oh.
You know, when you're small, you're like, I want to be a bride. Mm. You have all that plan. I was anti-marriage. I never believed in the concept of marriage and marrying someone because I always wanted to build something for myself first. Mm. And if someone comes, it's my plus. It's not... And I think that comes from a fact that when I was 15, my mother had this whole idea of you need to learn how to cook because tomorrow you get married.
It's very Indian thinking.
So I think from like a very early stage of my life, I was like very anti-marriage. Right. And then, so anyhow, I came here. I did a couple of films, which unfortunately didn't do well in box office. And I got my film with Ekta. And I just came back from Thailand for that shoot. And Ekta said, there is an offer for you to go to Big Boss. And she thought that it's a great opportunity because your movie is coming up. And let's try. I'm like, dude, my Hindi is not very good. You know, like, and I have to speak Hindi. You know, they're gonna throw me out of a show. What am I gonna do there? She's like, no. 3 weeks, good enough. You go, you come out, great publicity, all that. So I go to the show by thinking, I'm going to this show, which calls Big Boss, and I had no idea about this show. I'm like, oh, okay, 2 weeks, I'm great. So I go there, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, I'm losing. I'm like, guys, get me out. And they're like, no, you staying. You cannot go out. You staying.
So how long were you there inside?
I was there from the first day to last day. I was the first foreigner who lasted for so long.
Wow. That's predictable. Wow.
Yeah, so I couldn't get out of it. And so if you've watched my season, so you can actually see it. I'm so like angry at everyone. And I'm like, get me out of this place. And I'm telling to the camera, my manager, listen, we had a contract. Take me out
of here. Public andar ye baatein kar diye camera. Tell my manager to do this. Mere ghar pe ye bol do jaise wo bolne wale.
I used to talk.
Like they used to talk and I used to walk and I said, hey, bhai.
Achha, you were together with
her? Bahut gareeb hote hain yaar. Bahut
gareeb hote hain. It happens to all of us. So that's Big Boss.
But your Hindi improved in that? Big Boss?
Yeah. I became like, I was talking in Hindi, proper Hindi and fighting in Hindi. And like,
fighting in Hindi.
Yeah,
it's like a short course.
My Hindi became like, no, my Hindi actually just like took off. Exactly. Because it's kind of like, I need to know what
they're saying. Right? Yeah.
So Big Boss happened, and in that time I was dating my ex. And
you met him?
No. I met him before.
Okay, you met him earlier.
We were dating for like almost 2 years when I was in Big Boss.
Okay.
And we were very clear that I'm not going to talk about him or my relationship because that's just secretive, whatever. But I stayed in a show for so long, right? And it became kind of like, what's going on outside? I don't know. And suddenly I started getting gifts from him. I was getting like whatever clothes was coming wasn't from my agency or my people. It was from his family. Ah. There was, when there was Diwali, there was a gift from his mother with the whole jewelry thing. And I was like, what's going on? And I didn't understand the whole thing. Then it was Christmas, New Year. He called that saying that my families cannot wait for you to come back home. Aww. And I'm like, okay. So all that happened and, you know,
But then you were totally in love with him.
That point,
yeah.
Before that, I really liked the guy. We had because we dated for 2 years and we traveled together a lot. And it was a great relationship. It was
then
one
you
of
realized
the,
you were missing yeah. him and...
Yeah, and I missed him. And also, like, what happened is that I didn't want to be with anyone else. Because in the show, as you know, there are other people. And you kind of like, they try or whatever. Yeah. And it didn't, you know, it's like, you know how it is. Even for boys, right? Even for boys. It's not only for girls.
Yeah.
But all I want to, like, talk to was that person. So anyway, I came out of a show. And I think in 4 months, we got engaged. He proposed. I said yes. And then just like one thing back to each other. And then he starts saying that, listen, I don't want my wife to be part of industry because aww. I cannot handle the whole press and media and people following you and talking about our life. And that's just too much for me. And I think it came from the fact that I've worked for so many years.
Yeah.
And probably back of, you know, back my head, there was some place that I wanted a family and I want to have that, right? So I was like, okay, you know what? He's a nice guy. I've been with him for so long. He has passed all those levels of trust and all that, right? So why not? You know, I'm not going to lose anything. But I told him that I want to work and I'm going to work with you in your office. And we had ideas, all that. We got married and that was my biggest mistake because when any person ask you to change for them
that's
to be comfortable
the end.
True that.
To be comfortable with
that.
You that's the moment that you are mistaken and because what I didn't realize that I have worked so many years to reach that
where
state.
You are.
I know that
and this person has taken everything from me and as you said you know I really like what you said right now he said you know I appreciate my wife she has left her friends and family and country and all
which
that
is very
right?
tough
it is
she?
Right
very so tough.
Tough yeah
you see
yeah
this?
And so
it's called a tattoo.
So it's really sweet if someone actually appreciates that and you know talks about it. And
so you said no.
So with me, what happened is that the first week of my marriage was all honeymoon phase, whatever. And it started becoming like, oh, acha beta, you know, I think that you should stay home. Now you're married. No, just take cooking class. And I'm a girl that even I don't stay at my home like all day. Yeah, yeah. I'm out gymming, meeting my friends, working, working on something or the other, right?
Yeah.
And I feel like it was more of, okay, she's beautiful. She's going to give us babies. And she doesn't go to kitty parties. Mm. And she actually can handle our social level of whatever that
trophy
is.
Life.
Trophy wife. She's
and what surprised me until a date, and I don't have answer for it still, is that why the hell a man who has known me for so well, right? He actually thought that he can put me in a golden cage.
Yeah.
While I'm coming.
A story. I
why does
story
this happen? You know, while, this always happens with a lot of cases.
I don't know why.
You marry me for who I am.
Exactly.
All of a sudden, you don't like me for who I am.
Why do you want to change me?
And I think it's because, you know, we all have this, oh my gosh, she's so strong. She's so beautiful. Yes, yes, yes. But then, can we actually handle her for real?
Yep.
Can you handle her as your wife?
You said it. You said it, girl.
That's
they
true.
They can't.
Hey, listen, let's have like a guy.
You let it be. You let it be.
Suddenly bashing is going on.
She's giving a personal
example.
She's talking about.
Yeah, go
but that's
girl.
Exactly
go,
what
go,
happened.
But she's been through.
That's exactly what we've been through.
She's been through and she can relate to what you're saying.
You know, it's not about man bashing.
I'm from a Pathan Muslim family. Married to an Angrez. I told my family, brother, he left everything. इसको जो करना है वो करने दो कोई कुछ नहीं बोलेगा
यही तो चाहिए
ये
और क्या चाहिए
नहीं पहनने वाली ऐसा कुछ इसको जब दिल करेगा आई डिड नॉट फोर्स हर टू बिकम मुस्लिम
नो यू हैव हियर बट आई डोंट नो सी वेयर ही केम फ्रॉम मे बी ही हैड ट्रैपिंग्स ऑफ द फैमिली व्हिच ही हैड टू डील विद आई डोंट नो
एंड आल्सो लाइक द पार्ट इज दैट I'm a kind of person, if I don't understand something, then I move on. I don't waste my time. I try to fix it.
But you did give it a chance. You gave it a very good chance.
I give you another example, which a lot of people, they don't know, and I would love to actually talk about it, is that even his family, they start saying that, oh, you know what? This girl, she has married you because you are wealthy or whatever. So I said, first of all, hold on there. Hold on. I want your guy, your son, to come out of this mention that you're saying and to live with me in Bandra in a one-bedroom BHK. And I took the guy to that flat. I said, listen, this is a flat that I've seen. Me and you, we move here from all that fancy because I want to see if my relationship with you doesn't work, that means we are not working. But there are so many things between us, your brother, your mother, your this, your that, your house, your car, your society. But I'm not even reaching you. There's so many things in between.
The coffee tea.
True.
And it's a sad story. And it's not only about India. It's in Iran the same thing.
Yeah,
I don't understand why they say a girl has to marry the family. I'm sorry, no. I'm marrying
not
you.
Not in today's day and age.
You marry me.
I agree. But tell me one thing. Now, that's the separation happened. You went through heartache, I'm sure.
I was homeless overnight.
Wow.
So basically, I had to argue with my husband and my mother-in-law. She was just pushing it to a level that I might be strong, I might be open-ended and mufat basically, but I do respect for my older people, you know.
Fair enough.
And what I said, listen, mom, I used to call her mom. I said, mom, you're putting the level to the way that if I stay here longer, I'm going to say something that I'm going to regret it for the rest of my life. What I'm going to do, I'm going to pick up my bag, go to my best friend's house. When everything is calm, you tell my husband to come and pick me up. Which never happened.
Oh my God.
It was as simple as can get. And I wasn't allowed to my own house after that.
Wow. Oh.
You know. Anyway, hopefully, God willing, things are going to happen brilliantly.
Oh, we're talking, by the way.
Yeah, we're tell us.
If.
Tell
if,
us fast.
If, yeah.
Man, bright side so, is silver lining.
If you would have met me like a year and a half, right? I wasn't eating. I wasn't sleeping. I was just shocked. And I was like, okay, this happened. So what are you going to do now? Right? You're either going to fight with these people, you're going to make yourself miserable, or you're going to actually pick up the pieces and like start again, right?
So much
because if you...
So much with that.
Yeah, so if you've... And you understand what I mean, right?
He went through that.
Absolutely.
So, yes, and also, I was really lucky that I didn't have a child, you know?
Yeah.
So what I did, I got a small house for myself and I really started like working on myself. I was like, listen, it's okay, 2 years of break from the industry. I'll get back to that. Build it up. Start working, working, calling every single person in town.
Yeah, you can call. See what happens is, I think, very important. If you call up people, you shouldn't think, why should I call them? You're calling them for work.
Hey, bachchan saab, you are. Amrit Puri ka role chin liya hai. Subah subah walk pe jaake hai. Mohabbat mein Amrit Puri tha. Seriously?
No, I'm saying, काम के लिए.
सुबह उठ के वॉक पे गए बच्चे
चले गए. I feel there is no harm. You're not asking for money. You know, you're just saying, look, hi, Neha. I feel you're looking for someone. I feel I can fit that role because I'm qualified. What do you feel?
No harm. No harm at all.
Ask for money. Ask for work.
I agree with you. So well done, guys. Give Mandana a hand.
Oh, I want to finish.
Sorry.
I'm so sorry. I just want to finish in that point that year and a half ago, I had nothing. I was back to the hard rock, you know, just everything was over for me. That's how I felt. And today, I own my new business, which is Mandana's Kitchen.
Wow.
Such a lovely
Yes. That's the point I want to talk to you guys about.
Okay.
It's Mandana's Kitchen, and I cook really well. And I'm from Iran. We love kebabs.
Mm. Yeah.
Wow.
And it's a proper Iranian, authentic Iranian food.
Some khuda ki lunch
I'm importing.
Kebab ki baatein kar
rahe hain. So we are getting everything from Iran. All our ingredients.
Tell us what is it called?
Mandana's Kitchen.
Guys, Mandana's Kitchen. You all got to try together. Okay. Mandana's
Kitchen. Let's.
Bhai log, fan log, mere jitne bhi pyare, Mandana ke kitchen mein jaake kebab zarur khana.
And we are on Zomato, Scootsy, and Swiggy.
Okay, guys,
we
got
so
it. Okay. Now I'm going to introduce our late Latif guest.
Yeah.
The youngest and the cutest, Priyank Sharma.
Bhai, jitni bhi 15 se leke 18-20 ki ladkiyan hain. Dil samajh. Ye londe na yaar, matlab sab dhundla lage, tum par hi focus hai. मैं बोला ये है कौन यार ये बच्चा छोटा इसको गोद में लेके घूम नो ही सो क्यूट ओह माय गॉड
ओके ये है प्रियांक नाउ प्रियांक वाज अ कोरियोग्राफर विद शामक दावर
यू
फॉर 3 इयर्स
वाओ
ही इज अ ब्रिलियंट डांसर एंड गेस व्हाट ही हैज पार्टिसिपेटेड इन 3 रियलिटी शोज रोडी स्प्लिट्स विला एंड बिग बॉस अगेन ऑल इन 1 ईयर
All in one year?
Oh my God.
So there you have a reality superstar over here.
Yeah.
He loves doggies.
Aww.
And today, guys, I must tell you, and okay, Priyank, before we tell them about what you, Sameer, all are doing, we want to know, I haven't heard, I try to find out from everyone possible, girlfriend, who, where, hai, kaun hai, kya ho raha hai, aaj ki din, hum sabko ye bahut zaruri hai pata karna.
I'll definitely talk about that as well. So, to start up with me, I'm actually a software engineer.
Wow. Yeah.
So coming from a middle
another one, smart guy.
Oh, yeah. So coming from
he's a Wall Street broker. Yeah, you're a business.
और आप उन साला तो हम लोग हैं यार क्या बात है ऊपर लगा हुआ लड़कियों के लिए यार
ऊपर लगा हुआ लड़कियों के लिए
एक बिल्कुल पुराना चावल है एक दिल्ली का चावल है और एक अभी अभी छोटे चावल निकले
ये बासमती है
बासमती चावल
Okay, you're a software engineer.
So I'm a software engineer, guys. Like, so coming from a Punjabi, like
another Punjabi.
Yeah.
Another Punjabi in the house.
A Delhi boy.
Can I say तुम भी पंजाबी हो ना?
ये भी पंजाबी, ये भी पंजाबी.
पंजाबी और पठानों ने बचा लिया इंडिया को.
Now whatever
that once again iske baad puchna kyon baad mein
kyon baad mein puchna hai
priyank ki baat khatam ho jaye fir ajaz se puchenge punjabi ne kyon bataya pathano ne
so coming from delhi again you know having the typical mindset of parents which makes sense that you know education is the safest investment
of course
right that's what my mom and dad have been thinking because my dad belongs to a middle class family where he is into government service so there's no business background so they don't believe in taking risk in their lives at all
security
pehle ek fixed income hai unki and they are like quite solid for life and then me going ahead since I was dancing since I was a kid so I explored myself that I can dance looking at Hrithik Roshan like always you know on Iqbal ka jeena so I explored that okay hamara ladka naach sakta hai right so you know it was the same one family thing. Gathering yeah. you know we priyank nach ke dikha it's like priyank nach ke dikha ye sab
idhar show le dalo
bina sunao I'm just like you know let's just show it off so I've showcased from my family. So it has started from my family get together.
Natural.
From Doom Machale to, you know, Ikpal Ka Jina to you are my Sonia. Right? Main aisa kyun hoon, all of that. To a stage where I, for the first time, I actually got to know myself. So I never explored crowd in my life. So in sixth standard, my mother, when I shifted my school, she told one of my teachers that he's a dancer. So they were just playing an act and, you know, my teacher just took me that there's a new boy. So teachers used to really like me. I was, you know, the Chikna. White guy.
Chikna.
Yeah, the, like, I'm not a racist, guys. No, I'm not. Like, but yeah, I'm like the, you know, like how India is like that idealistically cute looking boy. I should be. Exactly, that Gora Chitta Punjabi Munda. So I was like teacher's favorite. So he was like, he will showcase it. So I danced it and the first time I saw the entire school was out. I was like, oh, yeah, I like it.
I can do it.
You know, I like few girls out there, like, liking my work. Oh, that's maybe my thing. So I tried exploring myself. That time I got to know that, you know, this can be my thing. So, chalo, maine kaha main engineering kar leta, mom. I need to join classes so that I can professionally take it ahead. Mama was like, okay, get the engineering degree. Mujhe diwar pe chahiye. So wo diwar pe maine lagwa di. Everything. So it's like, yeah. So it's like quite solid. I was right. Like, mom, now I want to go. So I was dancing with Shamak. So they have special potential batch.
Right.
So I did that for 2 years. And then Shamak offered me one of the contracts that please join the company, Priyank. And I was handling the Delhi team out there.
Okay.
I was never came to Mumbai.
Okay.
So I worked with him for 2 years. And then I won't say that I never wanted to act in my life because I was a dancer. Mera jo sapna tha, it was very small. That I'll crack a reality show, maybe like Dance India Dance, or maybe some or the other.
Ye Nach Baliye ki winner hai.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Right, so Nach Baliye.
Yeah.
But Nach Baliye is more about couples.
Couples.
Yeah.
Couples.
So and that not was dancer.
Right, yeah. So I thought, ki theek hai, aisa kuch kar lunga, and then I'll have my own studios and all, but you know how life is.
Yeah.
It never works according to like
what the... own plans.
So yeah, exactly. Yeah. So thanks to one of the casting directors out there, that's Deepna. So she saw me at one of the Shamak showcases. When I was dancing with the kids and, you know, with the props and all. So, I've started my journey then. And I told my parents that I need to take this professionally. Mummy, you have to open your hands.
My mind is gone.
But no, but they understood. You know, you have, if parents give you that authority to live your own life after a while, it was my responsibility to make
genuine talent. So, it happens.
So, I gave them some time and I made them believe in me. And they started believing in me. They're like, okay, do it. So, kiya maine dance kiya 2 saal and then suddenly I was lucky. I will be saying that I was God's child. That someone, Deepna, one of the casting directors, saw me there showcasing and she told me for the first time you can be an actor. I was 18-year-old kid that time. Yeah, so I was like,
abhi kitna hai? Abhi bhi to try
lag raha hai. 26. I'm 26.
A big boy ho gaya thoda.
Yeah. Right. So that time I was like, okay, fine. But I was like, chalo, let's try. And I was trying since then. Then for one of the ZTV shows, Creative Eye Productions called me and I was picked for this. I won't say that I have struggled.
So things just happened for you.
It just happened. Yeah, so I've been...
Which is very rare in the majority of the cases. Yes.
I've been God's child. Like I remember with Deepna. So when Shano ma'am, and she saw me when I was 17. And Shano Sharma.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She saw me and during that time, the Yashra Studios, that they were really interested and they used to keep pushing me that please take him, get him for the auditions and all. And I used to be like, imagine Yashra Studios. I was not even aware. And I was like, like, you know, I let it go like that. I let it go like that. So I was not aware of things.
Yeah, that's
like
destiny.
That.
Yeah.
So within time, I was like, okay, let's try. But that time, jab jhatka lagta na life ka, pehli baar. So first time when I got my first, aukat. You know, when you, in Delhi, and especially the Shamak world, you are the king because that's a small world.
Yeah.
But when you come to Mumbai, you're the tiniest fish in the... You're not even the fish.
Yeah.
You know,
the
first time you come, life hits you that, okay, this is the reality and there are people out there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I went for one of the shows and I gave audition and luckily, they selected me for one of the episodics for Pyar Tune Kya Kiya and that was my Zing Challenge. That was a Zing Challenge. That was my first thing ever happened. I went on the sets, being a non-actor. Imagine being a non-actor, no idea about acting. I go there and the first ever scene of my life is to cry.
Oh no. Wow.
And I'm like laughing. I have no idea how to act. I'm like going, I am sweating like a pig. I am going here and there. I'm like, how the, I will do this.
How this is? Minus.
So, director has all said that Priyank, you have to kill it. You look amazing on screen. You can just, you are the one, you're the face.
Just cry.
He got to know somewhere the way body language. In my first scene, I'll tell you, so my hands. So girl has lost her leg and I'm in the hospital. And my hands are here. And he's like, what the hell is wrong with you?
Bhai, jeb se haath to nikal.
Jeb se haath to nikal. The first thing, and I was like, mere tabhi halat kharab ho gayi thi. So I remember, and that for the first time, I waited for 2 hours because they got to know I'm one on actor, and I got replaced. Oh. And I remember, that was the first reality check when you're 18, and you've come to Mumbai telling your parents, and you know, that time social media has just came into the boom.
Yeah.
Of course, a Delhi boy coming from Delhi to Mumbai, it was all over my social medias, guys, that I am playing the in lead of
the
school. Now, I'm staying at one of my friends, that was Green Heights, if you know that building in front of so I'm staying at one of my friend's house. रात को 8 बजे मैं बालकनी में बैठा हूँ कि जिंदगी मेरी खत्म हो चुकी है. You know, you can't act. You feel like that. You go through that. And so I had a word with the casting director. I've announced it everywhere. My parents are really hoping it. So she was like, don't tell it. Just tell your parents that it never came. So I was like, okay, let's for 3 days, let's chill in Mumbai. I will go ahead and meet maybe more people. I did nothing. Went back to Delhi and started my dancing again. Again, an idea came that go for reality shows. Right, sorry for my bathroom, I'm really unwell. I went for the roadies and maybe I think everything was, my stars were in the favor. And I gave my auditions and you know, I had a mindset that you can't make it through a reality show, you can't. I always thought, roadies mein ghaliyan dete main. I was telling my mother, main roadies nahi ja sakta. I was telling my friends, yaar, roadies mein main nahi ja sakta. And you can't abuse, you know, that's something we all abuse in our lives.
Yeah. Right? Don't say we just heard you guys.
Right, we all do that, sorry.
Yeah. Well, right? Yeah, we all do that.
Kabhi na kabhi gussa aata hai, jaise we all
do. It's the best way to get out your
any emotion, kind of emotion.
When you learn a new language, it's real, it's good.
Yeah, so you know.
But tell me, Hindi mein zyada gaali dene mein maza aata hai ya English mein?
Wo English mein aata hai, yaar.
Dono mein.
Hindi mein bahut maza aata hai.
हमारी राष्ट्रभाषा है वो.
नहीं यार, मुझे somehow English में ज़्यादा मज़ा.
English पे sophisticated गालियाँ होती हैं यार.
अच्छा, roadies में तो बहुत होता है ना. Roadies has a lot of aggression.
I was telling myself that should I go for my, I can't abuse in reality shows because that's, you know, you've seen people out there and judges taking your cases out because they're judging you. They're over there sitting and judging you. And that's a very,
it's,
these are the shows which doesn't have, I won't say content, it doesn't have craft, like the typical, if I be very honest about it, people don't take it as the platform to showcase your dancing skills or maybe some crafty skills, I should be putting it across. People are available, hote hain, aa jaate hain, sabke sab. That time, no ma'am, I thought I have to change it and maybe if this is my journey, maybe I can change it and try to make some benchmark out there.
Wow.
Roadies happened, people like me, thank you so much. And they really loved my character because that's your real personality. And then I went to Splitsvilla because MTV called me and they were really keen. And I was like, now Splitsvilla? Because that's what, again, one of those shows out there. And so 4 days back. So 4 days back. So, you know, so now this was happening.
Swimming room mein utar dete hain, bole
jao. Arre yaar, jab pyar karo.
Kasam se yaar.
So before roadies, 2 years back, I just got broken up with the girl, basically.
Ah, now we come to
that.
So I just got like, you know, a little away from her as well. It was like mostly from one side, from my side to her. And she went to States. And she was settled there like for her studies. And she was my childhood friend. So we have been together since we were the same school, the same tuitions, the same classmates. So that's like the puppy mates, you know, it's the same thing, same family meeting each other.
Childhood,
you know, parents meeting, parents meeting each other and all, seeing the report cards, kiske zyada marks aaye. So all of that was, it was that.
That's so like, special. Yeah,
that was really special.
And?
So she went and it took me a little bit of time to move on, you know, because I've seen, I felt like some
part of me
where I used to meet her every day. And like, it's not like just for a few hours. It was like at a point in my life, it was like for the entire day we were together because the schooling was the same class, and then the same tuitions. And we were preparing for AIEEE and IIT preparations as well. So we used to have the same institutes as well. We used to go for
But you've not been in touch with her since she's gone?
No, I was in touch with her. But it's just that she was, it makes a lot of difference once you go to states, no?
I guess.
It
becomes
long distance.
Long story.
You and Neha have very similar story.
Is it?
Yeah, long distance. So, Mandana and Daljeet are a little. I don't know what I want to say, Rajad and Sameer.
So, you know, I discussed that story, part of me in Roadies. So, a lot of people think that what is it? Like how you just asked me. So, I'll clear that off now today. I went to Splitsvilla. I told because I was not dating, I can go to a dating show to maybe look or search for someone. So I was like, okay, fine, dating show. You know, maybe it can help me with my career as well. So let's go. Right? Maybe love, career, what's better than that? And I can move on also from maybe from a little bit. So over there, I met again, made connections with, and I came back from Splitsvilla. I understood, okay, reality. Now, when you're there in a reality show, you actually tend to bond with someone because you're living with them.
With them, 24 hours. See, this is what we were talking, how many but TV stars got married at a particular time. Yeah,
particular time. True. You might bond with them, you may not. It is not important. But because you get a reality check after once you come out of that particular zone in the place as well. So,
actually, at that time, married when you're doing
exactly. At that time, you get to know. You get to know. So, once I came out, I told the basically the girl I was with. So, I told her that, you know, after
let's
just
see
I
what
came.
Happens after this.
Another month, like, we were sitting with a set of friends out there, I remember. Infinity Mall. I was sitting at the parking and I was telling her that, you know, it's just because I saw that there were some feelings exchanging. So I was like, I'm not sure because it's my point in my career. I need to focus. I've come to Mumbai because there was a reason. And so I don't want to make it and stretch it and further, you know, put it somewhere there. So I just want to focus on my work and I think I can't, you know, go ahead. I made it very clear from my end. Like, you know, I made it very clear.
You know instead something? Going ahead. You know something? But I tell you one thing. Bacha single hai, but I tell you one thing. Hum log, obviously, I'm much older than all of you.
Yeah.
Hum log mein himmat nahi thi, very honestly. I see, I'm speaking to, listening to all of you. You don't want something to happen. It's not working out. You say, it's not happening. Yeah, it's not working out. Yeah. It's time to move on. We won't give each other grief. We won't live with each other together. Our times, I don't know about our times. I'm saying all our friends,
no,
when
you know,
we got
like
married.
To add here, I would like to add here that this kashmakash mein hum log jeete hai ki should we, because we look up to our parents, okay?
Right.
So my parents, or probably every one of us over here, I don't think they are really great as far as compatibility is concerned, but somewhere down the line, they have that thing to hold on to each other.
Which I don't know if it's good or bad.
Exactly. So we come with a very mixed feeling that are we supposed to do that? Because ultimately, you have to adjust somewhere. Now, where is that that tenacity or that resilience of everyone is where it's to each his own. You know, but somewhere down the line, you want to like really want to make it work. But at times, you're like, how much is too much?
Yeah, but you know, then, at least you are thinking like that. We were not allowed to think.
Yeah.
You were talking very young. You
got I'm still like pretty right there.
Right there.
No, because I'm saying me and my friends, I'm talking about everybody, our age group.
Yeah.
We've all been married 30 years plus.
Yeah.
It's like never in your mind did you ever think. You did think.
Yeah.
But you wouldn't have the guts to go forward and say, I'm moving on.
Yeah. I want to make happy.
You can't do it today. Like he said, he sat in the car. He told the girl, honestly, it's not happening. We could never. Reason is, mummy kya bolegi, papa kya bolegi, falana kya hoega, idhar kya hoega, dost yaar.
No, and also I think let's be honest about it. I feel women then were not financially independent.
Maybe that is the reason.
Let's
today.
Be honest Possibly. About
That's
it.
That's also
let's
a
be,
point.
I that think could be if we had, yes. if the women then at that generation had the financial independence, I don't think half of women would have gone through the shit that
you're right. Like she just said another thing right now. She was told after marriage, don't work. Which if any of us would not have done it, but in today she decided, no, I am going to because this is what I have been doing since when,
and
you accepted.
And I also feel we all are the byproduct of what our parents don't want us to go through.
Could be.
Yes, we all are byproducts of that.
Could be.
So
could
my
be.
Mom, she made sure that my daughter is independent, come what may.
You know, I've told my daughter the same thing. I said, there is no hurry to get married.
Yeah.
You get married the day you're financially able to take care of yourself, irrespective of who you're marrying.
And I also feel, why to burden the poor man?
Yeah, and marry
it's
the guy you
job
want.
To take care of me.
And that's the thing. And marry the person you want, irrespective of the baggage he came through. Because at the end of the day, if he's a good boy, you are happy.
Exactly.
If he's not a good boy, no matter who the mother and father are, you can't
be rude. Yeah.
It doesn't work like that anyway. Sameer ji, aapki profession. Ye chup hai kab se.
I am having a good life.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, guys. No, no,
you
I
know,
don't
we think... were not financially dependent. Look at us now. These men have done this to us.
I think...
I'll being an intelligent man, I'm keeping quiet.
So I've seen my parents obviously being in a beautiful marriage since last 27 years, touch wood.
Yeah.
So, you know,
yeah.
I've always seen, but obviously we all fight. We all fight when
we all fight.
When you're in a relationship, you fight. There's a very good term, I really understood that, and that is the difference between seeing each other, dating each other. What do you mean by asking out a girl?
Yeah.
And what is the difference between asking out a girl and a proposing a girl? So yeah. There is, this generation, I'm not like
counting. No, your generation.
Yeah, my generation. We guys.
For the current time.
If I'm seeing a girl, dating, asking, if I'm dating a girl. So you know this difference. I should be telling you guys there is a difference. And that time, I really felt that I was seeing that girl when I came out of that reality show, and she got upset. Obviously, in half an hour we became friends, and we were friends like great buddies. Yeah. Like great buddies chilling out together. Became great, you know.
Time is जिंदगी में बात ना करें उनसे.
Exactly. No, we became in half an hour. We were just chilling with our friends, chilling with each other. And after that, also we have met a lot of times. And then I got a call for another reality show from Viacom. That was Big Boss. And I was like, I have to now go. But she became that close as a friend that I was discussing. I used to discuss everything with her. One of the only Mumbai friends I used to have in Mumbai. So now, suddenly I went to Big Boss. So there was some other personal thing also, like Big Boss went a little here and there for me, and because something was another thing was happening, which you know how they well edited the shows are.
So, we all know.
Yeah.
We all know.
So, right?
Know.
So I'll tell you.
Is it edited well?
My concern was
they only show what you're doing in the show.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't
think. How did they edit?
At least they didn't with me, no. They can fabricate, they can't manipulate.
No, fabricate,
probably,
I doubt.
Yeah, probably yeah. Only no, in the promos, heard, but not in the main.
But episode. Manipulator, no. Yes, because a lot of people still thought that in a house when I was there, I never spoke to Kishwar or Prince. But we used to cook together and we used to suddenly fight while cooking and
so
while
maybe
dancing,
that's
whatever.
Yeah, so that,
but what they showed was the fight, not me and Prince actually like hanging out or even me and Kishwar talking.
That's the format. They want to show how people are fighting each other.
If it's not spicy enough, we won't.
Yeah,
we are not
spicy. That's how it is.
It's like my daughter constantly clued. I said, what's wrong with you here? Do something else. No, blah, blah, blah,
and
blah, 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 blah.
People like it. Let me be very honest. You guys really like it.
We are all
you guys don't get it,
you
guys are the people who say that TRPs are not so good. You guys are not entertaining us much. So you, actually people, they do like it. That's the truth.
Priyansh.
Yes.
आज बाय द वे गाइस समीर एंड प्रियंक्स न्यू वेब सीरीज
बात
इज आउट टुनाइट.
आई वाज एट द प्रमोशन ऑफ दैट जस्ट केम.
द प्रोमोस लुक outstanding.
So
you are
all
looking
got to watch that.
And I've heard
now I'm just going to be signing off because I think we've spoken enough.
I want to say something about Priyank.
Okay, now
just very quickly. Because
okay, before we sign off,
he started off saying that he was a non-actor and he couldn't cry and stuff. We've had a lot of scenes together, and honest to God, I mean, this guy is so good. He's so good. I think he's the next big thing that's going to happen in film.
He, by the way, said that. He said that
he's
about
the next,
you.
I, in fact, after seeing the screening, I told him that if you don't make it, I'm going to quit. Because he's got.
You know, Ravana sir.
No.
I remember that.
His presence is incredible, and his performance, considering it's the first project he's done seriously, is highly commendable.
I'll tell you today, when I was coming, I was talking to a friend. She saw the first episode of Punchbeat, and she was raving about this guy.
Yeah.
He's so hot, he acts so well.
Yeah, girls are gonna. And he's got
young,
like,
now
he's
you
got,
have an option. Choice. Bulaun, na bulaun, jaun, na jaun, date karu, na karu, aage.
All the decisions were right, Priyank. Good job.
Dekhunga, isko main date
karunga.
Listen to your instinct. You're doing a good job.
And he's got 12 pack, not 6 pack. 12 pack.
Yeah, that girl went gaga. I think the introduction or something. She was talking about it. So Punchbeat, guys, watch it.
So folks, thank you so much. This was a Valentine special. And I'll just tell you why I didn't. I was asked earlier by our friends at Facebook, especially Divakar, that Valentine means couples. So I said, I am not getting a single couple because you are most dishonest with each other. I agree, good job. So it's all of us singles here, singles in the cell, whatever way you look at it. Yeah. Because if my husband was here, trust me, I would have said 30 things. I'll say, oh shit.
Abhi nahi,
baad mein dekha jayega. And it happens with everybody. So therefore, thank you Mandana, Priyank, Ajaz, Daljeet, Neha, Sameer.
Thank you for
and thank you all for being here. And see you soon next week.
Wait, like, maine gana likha hai abhi Gully Boy hone ke baad. Mera song maine record kiya. I want to sing that song.
Okay.
Ek second na? Chal, theek hai.
Suno mere bhai log, mere aane wale dialogue. English mein kya bolte hai banta hai? Haan bhai, monologue. इस दुनिया में जो आता है अपनी किस्मत का खाता है सच्चा दिल हो जिसके अंदर वही एक नंबर कहलाता है हाँ मैं हूं एक नंबर माय फ्रेंड्स एक नंबर टेंशन नहीं लेने का हम सब एक नंबर जनता के लिए नेता है पर
हमारे लिए
नेता के लिए जनता नहीं झूठा सपना दिखाई जो नेता ऐसा नेता अपने को जमता नहीं मेरी मां दुनिया से जा चुकी है एक बात मुझे बता चुकी है हम सब कुछ पीछे छोड़ जाएंगे बस अच्छे कर्म काम आएंगे
True.
बुराई को छोड़ के अच्छाई का साथ दे बुराई को छोड़ के अच्छाई का साथ दे बुराई को छोड़ के
अच्छाई का साथ दे ये थैंक यू एंड सी यू ऑल वेरी सून ऑन सीजन 2 एपिसोड 2 ऑफ रियल और रियल विद अनु थैंक यू कट